a new year, a time of new beginning in the church, and therefore in our lives, if we let it be, a time to look back with thanksgiving and forward in anticipation. Our first reading from Isaiah is very Barbadian. He cries out, his God, oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down. I picture Isaiah all those years ago, wishing that God would make himself known one more time, like he used to do in the old days. Because Isaiah's words are exactly the kind of thought echoed by an old woman called Ellen, who used to live in the top of Breakneck Hill, there by us. Because Ellen was frequently exasperated by the course of developments in Barbadian society, and she would often lament, Lord, come for your word. That is basically Isaiah's message. Lord, come down. Isaiah longs, he longs for a fresh revelation of God. He says it was all so simple in the past. When we sinned, you punished. When you called, we came. When we were obedient, you met us joyfully. Life is not so simple now, he says. But you know, one thing is still certain. You are our Father. We are the clay, you are the potter. We are all the work of your hand. That's good news. So look at the good news now. Some people, when they come to church, have a shirt of face. Miserable. Good news, as we celebrate 48 years of independence, by a show of hands, please, who was there that night, 48 years ago, at the garrison? One, two, two and a half, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, not sure. I was there. I was the year when the Union flag came down and the blue, gold, and black flag of Barbados went up. And again, independence Barbados was following in the footsteps of Jamaica, Trinidad, and Miami. And the last thing the British gave us was the rain. It rained that night, and it rained the day before, and it rained the day before that. And as you know, Barbados don't come up here in another. I am descended from the slave and the slave owner. some sense or place in the order of things. Who came to England before 1980? Put your hand up. Keep your hand up before 1970. Keep your hand up before 1960. Oh, what's happening now? Before 1950? Good Lord. Thank you. these three words that see us through anything at any time. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 9, God is faithful. That's it. God is faithful. Because in our childhood, whether we ourselves accepted it or not, we were surrounded by the fact of God as a close friend. We had this rich heritage in our schooling, in our extended families, and each of you will have your own particular hero who brought Christ to you. And today, so far from home, because it's always home, no matter how long you've been away, it's always home. And it's a different world now, here and there. You have all those channels on TV, nothing too much to watch on any of them. But we hear of carnage and murder in Nigeria, Syria, Afghanistan, Iran, Palestine, Israel, Ukraine, Crimea, India. And how many black families in London and our other cities know that experience of standing by the coffin of their son or their grandson, stabbed by a rival gang? These are the descendants of those who came to England in the 1950s for a better life. Now lying bleeding in the streets of our cities. We who grew up in Barbados, we remember a contentment, a calm in our life, a satisfaction with our lot. Remember the prophet Job? Your old men will dream dreams, your young men will see visions. We've just had a tremendous, horrendous recession, where many young have no work, and the old can't sleep at night. Look at the locks on the doors, the rods iron on the windows. Every time you go back home, there's another piece of wrought iron. My grandmother, like yours, did not possess a key. The front door is never locked. And we go back home, and home is different. And we are different. We perceive a creeping resentment sometimes in some places of white tourists. A huge resentment of Barbadians who have lived abroad. And when they see us in the queue in line at the post office and in the bank, I swear they slow down. Received was in Bath that Rebecca Raffin Aline, a widow, died on the 30th of March, 1846, having lived the last 13 years of her life in genteel poverty after slavery. light shining in the darkness, not the artificial light from the store for which no spirit can be found, but the true light that enlightens every human soul. And the brightness of that light will be in direct proportion to the amount of preparation we have made, not outside our houses, but in our hearts. And if we prepare simply for a birth of a child, we shall be no better than the world in general. Because the world is good at births, but the baby grows, and the baby challenges us to follow him to and through the cross. A Savior to set us free. So if each of us could ask ourselves now, what is it that imprisons me? Not slavery anymore, please God. So what is it? A refusal to let go? A refusal to let go of the past? A refusal to make a new beginning? A refusal to not be defined by what other people think we should be? A refusal to be grateful for what we have? A refusal to forgive? Father, we are all broken. On the 8th of December 1941, the Japanese invaded Malaya, and Singapore was captured. And the Bishop of Singapore, Leonard Wilson, was thrown into that hellhole called Changi Prison. He was tortured. He was crowded with too many other inmates. He couldn't lie down. The only water was in the toilet. There was no soap. He couldn't speak. There was no bedding. There were no covers. And the Bishop asked for courage. And he asked that his tormentors might be forgiven. 2 years later, after the war ended, Malaya, Singapore was liberated. The bishop was invited back to a confirmation. And they came up to him two by two to have the bishop's hands laid on his head in confirmation. And his hands were scarred because he'd been tortured in that prison 2 years previous. And as one man came to kneel before him, he recognized that face. He recognized the man as one of the guards in Chinese jail. That man who contributed to his torture, the disfigurement of his hands. And the bishop looked up in the eye and laid his hands on his head and firmly.
That prison, when we did those things to you and when you prayed,